Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this general problem, they tell us that the ramp in the figure is frictionless, and if the blocks are released from rest, which way does this 10 kilogram block slide, and what is the magnitude of acceleration? So this one is 10 kilograms, and this one is a 5 kilogram block. And first off, let's go ahead and sum the forces. So for block over here, we'll say that this one is block one, the smaller one. We have weight coming down, obviously, and then we have tension going up. For block, so that one's one, we'll call this one block two. We're going to be using a tilted grid. So this is the x-axis, and then here's the y-axis. So the normal, as we know, is always perpendicular to the surface, so the normal's there. Weight always goes straight down, so weight like that. This angle, the figure says, is 40 degrees. And so this figure here, so that angle there is also 40 degrees. And then we have tension going there, and they say that it's a frictionless ramp, so that's all the forces for this one. Let's start with block one. As we talked about in the last video, these pulley problems, they're such fodder for tests. Your physics professors love these guys. It's just like, it's like their addiction. I got to put a pulley problem on the test kind of a thing. So really pay attention with these ones. For block one, though, what we're going to do is sum the forces. It's in the y direction, obviously. So sum of the forces in the y. We have tension minus the weight is equal to a negative mass one times acceleration. The acceleration is in the negative y direction, so that's why we have the negative right there. We can change this to mg. So we have T minus M1G is equal to negative M1A. And then we want to isolate T, so let's add this over to the other side. So we have tension is equal to G, which is positive now, minus M1A. So now we're done with this one, and let's go to block two. So block two, and we'll sum the forces in the x direction now. But as you know, we already talked about it's going to be a tilted axis, so we'll need to remember that. So in the x direction, we have a positive tension, and then we have the x component of gravity. And in this case, it's opposite to this angle here. We talked a lot about this in chapter 3 on inclined plane problems. If you want to go review why these two angles are the same, that's where you need to go. But for this, we're just going to assume that you already know why, that they're the same, and it's opposite of the angle. So we're going to minus, because it's going in the negative x direction. So it'll be minus m2 times g sine of theta. And then that will all be equal to mass 2 times the acceleration in the x direction. And let's do this. We're going to take this right here, and let's substitute the T for the block 1 in for block 2. So now we have M1G minus M1A, and then everything else is the same, M2G sine theta. That's a 2. Equals m2 times the acceleration. And now we need to solve this and simplify it for the acceleration. But the accelerations are all on the correct sign, so we already accounted for the signs of the acceleration up here, so we don't need to worry about acceleration 1 or acceleration 2. The signs are correct as they are written. So we want to get everything with the acceleration on one side and everything else on the other. So we'll have m minus m2g sine theta, and then that will be equal to m2a plus now m1a. And what we'll do, of course, is let's factor out the acceleration. So all this is the same, minus m2g sine theta, and then we'll equal acceleration m2 plus m1. Let's come down space. These pulley problems, they take so much room. All right, so now we want to isolate acceleration, so we'll divide both sides by m2 plus m1, and then we'll go like that, m2 plus m1, And I know we talked about, like I was just saying, they take a lot of space, but it's really important to write all the steps. It will really show your grader you know what you're doing, so it'll save you a lot of points on your test. And if you make a mistake on these, which it's really easy to flip a sign or do something, you can catch it much easier. And if you don't, maybe you'll get some partial points or something. So let's rewrite this. And before I do that, let's factor out g for all of this. So acceleration will finally be equal to g, and then that is m1 minus m2 sine theta. I guess I can't write twos today. And then all that is divided by m2 plus m1. That last step where we factor out the g, you don't have to do it. We're just being really thorough. It just makes it a little bit simpler, looks a little cleaner. So now we're ready. Now let's plug in our numbers. So we have acceleration is equal to 9.8 meters per second squared times m1 is the smaller mass. So we had 5 kilograms. And then it's minus 10 kilograms times the sine of the angle, which in this case was 40 degrees. Let's double check I got that angle right. Yeah, 40. Okay. So now all of that is divided by the total mass, which is 5 kilograms plus 10 kilograms. I wrote them m2 plus n1, and then I flip-flopped them here. It's the same thing, obviously. So coming to our calculator, we have 9.8 meters per second squared, and then we're timesing 5 kilograms minus 10 times the sine of 40. Okay, and now all of that will be divided by 10 plus 5, so 15. So the answer is negative 0.93. And what is that? That's acceleration, so negative 0.93 meters per second squared. One thing, though, I don't like when they do this. They said, what is the magnitude for this? And so the magnitude is going to be positive 0.93 meters per second squared. So that is the magnitude of the acceleration. But to answer the question, will it go up or will it go down the ramp? Since we're doing the equation for block two, the bigger one, let's come up and show you on the picture. If the answer is negative, that means it's going in the negative x direction. So it's going down the ramp. Obviously, our answer is negative. So the acceleration will be 0.93 meters per second squared down the ramp.